Welcome to Control Engineering Playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you types of feedback in this video. So to understand types of feedback, here in this session, we are dealing with to understand two different types of feedback. One is negative feedback and second is positive feedback. Here in this session, we will see what is negative feedback and we will derive transfer function for negative feedback. And at the end, we will see applications for negative feedback. And same thing that we will do it for positive feedback. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is what is negative feedback. So when we talk about negative feedback, then negative feedback in closed loop system identifies feedback should be negative with respect to input signal. So what it means? It means when we subtract feedback signal with respect to input, then it will be considered as negative feedback. Second definition could be as if feedback signal is out of phase with respect to input signal, then one can say that feedback is negative feedback. Right. So let us see the block diagram first, which is there with negative feedback. So here we have input signal, and that input signal that we give it to this error detector, and second signal to this error detector is feedback signal, which is coming from output side, and error signal will be input to this system G, and this H is gain of feedback. Now here, if you observe output of this system G, that is C of S, and that is input to the system H, right? And here we have negative feedback. So here with this feedback, I'm placing negative sign. What it means? It is negative feedback. So it explains our error signal E of S, that will be difference in between input and feedback signal. So E of S, that has to be R of S minus F of S. Now let us try to understand first what will be my output of this feedback system. So feedback system output, that is F of S, and that we can identify as per input C of S. So output F of S, that will be input into gain. So here input is C of S and gain is H. So F of S, that will be H into C of S. Now here we have system G. So it is having input which is E of S, that is error signal, and output is C of S. So as per that, output C of S, that has to be input into gain. So input is E of S into gain is G. So C of S, that is G into E of S, that one can see. Now, as I have told you, this is error detector, and output of error detector, that is E of S. And here I have placed negative sign. What it means? Error signal E of S, that will be input minus feedback signal, which is F of S. So we can say error signal E of S, that will be R of S minus F of S. Now here we can place values of E of S as well as F of S from these equations. Why we are placing values of E of S and F of S from these equations? The reason is we wanted to have transfer function. Now what is transfer function? Transfer function is a ratio of output to input. Right, so it will be C of S divided by R of S. Now here E of S, that we can place it in terms of C of S, and F of S, that we can place it in terms of C of S. So at the end we can have this equation in terms of R of S and C of S, and from that we can identify transfer function, which is C of S divided by R of S. So let us place E of S, that is C of S divided by G, and F of S, that is H into C of S, you can see. Now to have transfer function C of S divided by R of S, I am just taking this term over this side, right? And if I take LCM of 1 by G, then you will be finding C of S into 1 plus HG is equals to G into R of S. So based on this equation, we can have transfer function, that is C of S divided by R of S is equals to G divided by 1 plus GH, where G is gain of system and H is gain of feedback link. right? So one should remember this negative feedback closed loop gain, that is G divided by 1 plus GH. And in block diagram reduction, even we will be using this formula to have a solution of block diagram reduction, right? So in negative feedback, we subtract feedback signal with respect to input. That's why it is referred as negative feedback. Or one can say in negative feedback, feedback signal will be out of phase with respect to input signal. Now, there should be question like where should we utilize negative feedback, right? So negative feedback applications that has been used to stabilize the gain. Now, what is the meaning of stabilization of gain? If you observe, this system gain is G, right? Now, if system gain is G and that is very high, then we need to stabilize that gain. How do we stabilize that? By using negative feedback. Now, you see, after negative feedback, your gain will be G divided by 1 plus GH, right? So, here we are reducing gain by having closed loop system using negative feedback. Right, so negative feedback is used for stabilization of gain. Sometimes we use negative feedback as amplifier even. In which applications? Where we have H very less than 1, we can have amplification even. And that is what we use it in operational amplifier. You might have used that in some applications whereby using op-amp, we use this negative feedback as amplifier. In analog to digital converter and in digital to analog converter even, we can use negative feedback, right? So these are the applications which is very popular with negative feedback. Now let us see positive feedback. So when we talk about positive feedback, then one should know, see here we add feedback signal with input signal, it will be a positive feedback. Or one can say feedback signal will be in phase with input signal. So as if feedback signal that is there in phase with input signal, then that feedback is referred as positive feedback. So here we have closed loop control system, right? And this is my feedback signal f of s. So here if this is what having positive sign means we are adding this feedback signal with input signal and that is generating error signal means this feedback is positive feedback. And here even gain of the system is G and gain of the feedback link is H. Output is C of S, error signal is E of S, feedback signal is F of S and input signal is R of S. Now first our agenda is to identify transfer function, that is C of S divided by R of S. So again, if I see this system H, which is feedback system, which is having input C of S and output F of S, then F of S that will be input C of S into H. So F of S that is H into C of S. Now, if you see this system G that is having input E of S and output C of S, then output C of S that is equals to input into G, right? So C of S that is input into G, input is E of S and G is gain of this system. Now here error signal that is addition of input and feedback. So here error signal E of S that is R of S plus F of S. Now to have transfer function, we will place this E of S and F of S from these equations in this equation. So we can place E of S that is equals to C of S divided by G and F of S that is S into C of S. Now if you take LCM, by taking this C of S over this side, you will be having C of S into 1 minus GH is equals to G into R of S. So based on this equation, we can have transfer function and that transfer function is what? Output C of S divided by R of S and that will be G divided by 1 minus GH. So this is transfer function of positive feedback. And this is very essential formula, one should remember this. And in examination even, there could be question based on block diagram reduction where we have positive feedback. In that case, that transfer function will be G divided by 1 minus GH. Now let us discuss some applications which is there with positive feedback closed loop system. So applications are there with oscillator. You will be finding in oscillator we use positive feedback, as well as in timing circuits we use positive feedback. So you will be finding in analog electronics, when I'll teach analog electronics, in that we will make some oscillators where we'll be using positive feedbacks, right? So these are the popular applications which is there with positive feedback. I hope that you have understood this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. The reason is your suggestions are motivating me, and based on your suggestions, in future I'll be making videos which will be solving queries of the students. So please give your positive suggestions.